All right, there has been a lot of talk lately about mobile security at the Olympics. It was reported that laptops and smartphones would be hacked within minutes.
Well, those reports were almost entirely debunked, but it does raise concern about security and our personal devices. Shelley Palmer's here. He's our tech expert, and he's going to show us how to protect ourselves from hackers anywhere we are.
Don't click on anything that you don't know.
Like, just give me an example, because I'm always, so things are happens. Popping up, and I'm like, yeah. Click, you know.
No, here's what happens. In this report that was on NBC, it was really unfortunate, because it said that within minutes you'd be hacked if you turned on your cell phone or turned on your PC, if you went on a public network, like a public Wi-Fi network.
While you were in Russia.
While you were in Russia. Now, as it turns out, what they were showing could happen to you right here, and that's right. Why I thought it'd be important to talk about it right here. What hackers love to do is take a public event, an important event, like the World Cup in soccer or the Super Bowl, or in this case, the Olympics, and they love to get you to click on stuff that you shouldn't be clicking on. Now, when someone sends you an email and it's from their AOL account, which they haven't had in years, and it looks like it's a bad email and it's got a link in it, you know not to click on it. When you get the note from the guy in Nigeria who's got the $100 million for you, the Nigerian prince,
right.
You know not to click on it. But what people don't know is that when your friend sends you something about the Olympics, or I can get an Olympic sweatshirt for $2 or something, you know, that looks amazingly too good to be true, it is too good to be true. And if someone sends you an email that you think you know, but you don't know why it has a link in it, don't click on it. I just can never say it enough. Don't click on something you don't know. If you don't know what it is, don't click on it. Now, that's thing one. Thing two is, and the only thing in that report that I even liked a little bit, was on a public Wi-Fi network, you are a little more vulnerable than you are on what's known as a virtual private network. So if you could use your phone network, I know that we were just talking about expensive phone bills,
right.
You can use your phone data network, that's almost always safer. In fact, it is always safer than going on a public Wi-Fi network. But if you've patched your computer and you're using good virus protection software, a public network, like in Starbucks, is fine.
Do we have targets on us if we travel overseas as Americans? You know,
no.
If you take your cell phone now. I remember it wasn't that long ago, just a couple of years ago, that if you wanted to travel and you didn't have, you had to get a special phone from your carrier to go to
right.
Europe.
Yeah.
Now, a lot of times you can just take this
you
phone.
You can
and it
take
works.
Your phone. Look, the phone thing, we can do a whole segment on how much it costs to take your phone from here to there.
Right.
But what I will tell you is that the internet is completely global. And geolocation, the only reason that you would be more vulnerable in a foreign country is that foreign sites that you will not be able to translate or understand by default show up higher in a Google search when you're in a foreign location, because Google knows where you are and it goes, oh, you must be interested in the Starbucks that's here on the corner, not the one that's by your house back home, or you must be interested in the store that's here on the corner in Italy as opposed to the one back home. And so sites you wouldn't understand and sites that you would not necessarily be aware of will show up higher in a search, go, that must be the right site to click on. Not necessarily. That's the only danger of traveling,
okay.
Right? Other than that, just if you don't know the site, don't be clicking on stuff. If you don't know the sender, don't be clicking on stuff. Don't be clicking. It's that simple. It's never going to be a different story.
What's your Twitter?
You at Shelley Palmer or ShelleyPalmer.com.
There
Shelley,
you go.
Thank you very
Shelley.
Much.
All righty.